think when Jesus turned his water into wine, do you think there was connoisseurs at that meeting? Just, you know, good show, Jesus, but actually it's white wine with fish. Just mentioning it. Just. Do you know what I was watching that televangelist today? He was talking about the Last Supper. Here's the thing. Jesus stood up at the beginning of that meal and said, "Tomorrow, one of you will betray me." Fucking bon appetit. I can't help feeling after that the meal might have got a wee bit awkward, don't you? People just, "Oh, it was a bit of a bombshell, wasn't it?" "Who'd you think it was?" "Oh, I don't know. It's a nice new suit Judas has got on, isn't it?" Must have been a weird meal that anyway, because Jesus broke bread. He said, "This is to represent the breaking of my bones." Pours red wine, says, "This is to represent the spilling of my blood." I'm not a fussy eater, but I'd have probably gone, "I'm not that hungry anymore, you know." I sure as hell ain't touching the meatballs. Was that the line? Was that the line? All right, okay, I'm back. Another. But no, wine is an interesting thing. I went on a wine tour, actually, in Australia. I've never been on a wine tour before. Been on pub crawls. It's not quite the same thing. You get your cock out in a wine tour, nobody laughs. And I mean nobody, the whole bus froze. I said, "I've misread this entirely, I'm so sorry." I thought it'd be the same as a pub. Right, okay, I'm down with that. Yep, I'll take my seat, that's fine. It was very interesting, actually. It was good fun, actually. There was a couple from England on the tour. It was just the three of us, actually. Made the whole cock-out thing a lot more embarrassing. Very posh couple from Surrey in England, and they were sort of wine connoisseurs. And we went to this winery, and it was quite exciting. It was quite good fun, really. But the thing is, you're supposed to go for a tour of the vineyards first and then to the wine tasting. But who wants to do the vineyards? Jesus, you've seen one grape, you've seen them all. And the exciting bit is the actual wine tasting. We got to the very first winery, and there was a little kind of plinth, and I was standing here. His wife was there, and this gentleman was at the end. And we got the very first wine came out, and he picks up his and, you know, "Oh," he says, "oh, what a wonderful aroma. I'm getting the essence of strawberries and these blueberries and a little bit of banana and lime and, ooh, touch of apricot and some raspberry." I'm thinking, what? Has this guy got a smoothie or something? Is he? I've just got wine in my glass. we drink that, right? Then his wife, she picks up hers. She's got a dry wine. "Oh, very ochre and smoky and nutty. And almondy and dusty and barky." We neck that. I'm going, this is harder than I thought. And then it's my turn, right? The little wine comes out. It's my turn. I says, "Look, do you know what? Just forget about me. I don't really know what I'm doing." The guy says, "Don't be ridiculous, monkey boy. You say the first thing that comes into your head, you see? The essence of what you say, you say. You smell, and you smell. And you're, hey." I said, "All right, I'll give it a go. I'll give it my best shot." I picked up this glass. I went, crushed grapes.